Naruto, One Piece, and Bleach, also once known as the Big Three. Out of all these three series, Bleach was the one series that I never understood how it got its place in the upper echelon of popular shonen series at the time. It must have been sales and popularity because it was honestly never on the same level as Naruto or One Piece. I honestly don't remember having any friends that actually watched Bleach growing up, now that I think about it. Despite it not being nearly as successful as Naruto or Dragon Ball, one thing is for certain, that Bleach has its dedicated fan base. Earlier this year, it was announced that Bleach would finally be returning to cover the last story arc, the Thousand Year Blood War. While many fans were excited, I wasn't exactly jumping for joy at the thought of more Bleach. I'm a very casual Bleach fan, and I have watched a large chunk of the series up until the final episode. I was happy when the final episode aired, and thought to myself, finally, it's over! Can we be honest, guys? Bleach ended 3 or 4 times over, and it just didn't know when to end. Not to mention the constant switch up by series creator Tite Kubo in terms of what Ichigo is and his ever-expanding power set, but that's a topic for another day. Anyway, alongside the announcement of a new Bleach anime, a limited manga and anime series called Burn the Witch was also announced. After watching the preview for the anime, I was immediately sold on it due to just how different the world and setting was to Bleach. I was a million times more excited for this new anime than Bleach returning. When I read that it was set in the same world as Bleach, I was a bit deflated simply because this looked like it could stand on its own. After watching Burn the Witch, I truly believe it was unnecessary to tie Reverse London into Bleach's Soul Society. Its small Bleach connection doesn't ruin the story or anything, but it kinda sucks that it can't be its own separate thing. Outside of a throwaway line from one of the main characters, Nini Spaincole, in the one-shot and the Soul Society reference at the end of the one-shot in the anime, there really isn't any significance to these two properties sharing the same world. That being said, Burn the Witch was awesome. If the new season of Bleach could be canceled for more of this, I'd totally be down for that. I know it would piss a lot of people off, but I would be down for that. The name Tite Kubo meant nothing to me before watching this anime or reading the manga, but now I've taken notice of his talent in a lot of areas in which I wouldn't have expected. Not only does Tite Kubo deserve praise for this series, but the animation studio that brought it to life, Studio Colorido, deserves recognition as well. Despite Burn the Witch being promoted as a 3-episode series on Crunchyroll, it was actually distributed as a film and therefore has the production values of a feature film as opposed to a standard show. Not only is the animation high quality, but the soundtrack was excellent too. I've played the ending song, Blowing, on repeat several times daily ever since the anime premiered, and while I haven't gotten to listen to every track fully yet, the ones I did hear were great. The music really fit every scene and the animation was very smooth. This anime really benefited from having a movie budget, with the trade-off simply being less time to explore other aspects of the world and its characters. Before I go any further, let me explain the basic premise of Burn the Witch for those that are unfamiliar with it. Burn the Witch is an action fantasy story centered around two witches, Nini Spaincole and Noelle Nihashi, working at the Western branch of the Soul Society in Reverse London. You could think of Reverse London as the flip side or the mirror of London, where its inhabitants can perceive the presence of dragons. As members of the Piper's Unit, Nini and Noelle's job is to conserve and protect these creatures, since many of them are used as natural resources. Nini and Noelle are also responsible for protecting Bogo Parks, a guy from Noelle's high school who became dragon-clad, and his pet dragon dog named Osushi. The anime and limited manga series takes place after the events of the one-shot manga. There's a lot of stuff in the one-shot manga that isn't in the anime or in the limited manga series. Certain scenes, such as when Nini was talking about repairs near the entrance where the big screen was located, or the very last scene where Noelle was chasing Bogo and Osushi, are taken directly from the one-shot. The events that led up to Bogo becoming dragon-clad are excluded since they took place before the series. I hope that we could maybe get the one-shot adapted into an OVA in the future, or maybe have parts of it included in flashbacks for a possible next season or next film, because there are parts of it that would really add on to Bogo's backstory and character, and I think just a lot of it would be fun to really see. Anyway, both the anime and manga were paced very well, although one common complaint that I've seen is in regards to the amount of exposition in the one-shot manga. I don't think it's as bad as some people made it out to be. I mean, Kubo only had 63 pages to tell his story, and it's not like the majority of the manga is exposition. One aspect of Burn the Witch that Kubo handled masterfully is its tonal shifts. I was surprised by just how funny this was and impressed by how seamlessly Kubo switches from action and drama to comedy relief. In my opinion, he strikes a perfect balance between humor and everything else. There was never a time where the comedy relief felt forced or out of place. The combination of Kubo's humor and the artwork in the manga or anime give Burn the Witch its own distinctive personality. I don't recall Bleach having this much personality in terms of its characters or its comedy being anywhere near as funny as what we're given in the series. Also, I can't stress enough just how much I love Kubo's artwork in the manga. I've never read the Bleach manga, so I never noticed just how good of an artist he is. I always knew that he could make some really cool looking character designs. I mean, just look at how cool Grimmjow Jabberjax looks. Kubo's artwork, especially the way he draws the expressions on characters' faces, really brings out their personality and makes the comedy work. Some of these facial expressions are just pure gold. I can see the internet going crazy using a lot of Ninny and Noelle's reactions as meme material. The humor always worked for me, and I love how expressive the characters are, especially when Ninny is irritated or angry. In regards to the characters, I really like every major character that Kubo presented to us. That is something that I couldn't really say about Bleach, as it had way too many characters I didn't care much about. If I had to pick a favorite character, it would probably be Ninny because of her personality and interactions with characters like Bogo and the Piper's Chief, Billy Banks Jr. The character has a short temper, is very forthright, ambitious, opportunistic, and aggressive. She's the perfect foil to Noelle, who has a much calmer and somewhat indifferent attitude. These two are balanced out by Billy Banks Jr., who's very laid back, and Bogo, who's a clueless idiot. The dynamic between these characters was a lot of fun to watch. I only have two minor gripes in regards to the characters, and that would be their voices and names. The voices for characters like Osuchi and the later introduced Macy Balger and Bruno Bangknife were great. Noelle's voice was fine, but I didn't like Ninny and Billy's voices. They just didn't sound the way I thought they should after coming from the manga. I really can't wait to hear these voices in English. As I was reading the manga, I could already imagine how these characters could sound and who should voice them. Erica Mendez, who voiced Ryuko in Kill la Kill, should voice Ninny. The voice of Billy should be done by Ray Heard, who did Kizaru in One Piece. The voice of Macy should be done by Sarah Roach, who voices Maki in Fire Force. And Eric Vale, who does the voice for Arthur Boyle in Fire Force, should voice Bogo. I'm not sure about Noelle, but those are just some of my casting choices that I had in mind. Anyway, my second issue with the characters is with their names. I know this is a minor issue, but I thought I should still point out just how bad some of these names are. The names for some of the higher-ups at Wingbind, the place that Noelle and Ninny work, are terrible. The director of Sacreds has a name so bad I won't say it because I'm not trying to get demonetized. When I first read the part in the manga where the Top of Horns, the group in control of Wingbind, is first introduced, I had to do a double take when I read her name. I'm surprised nobody told Kubo that he had to change that. To be fair, not all the names are bad, and at least the character designs were unique and each director had a distinct personality. In regards to the story of Burn the Witch, it's good, but it's not amazing. The central conflict stems from Bogo and his dragon-clad status, and how his existence could possibly pose a threat to the citizens of Reverse London. I'm hesitant to say much more than that because I don't want to risk spoiling anything. What I can say is that some of this might feel familiar to anyone who has seen a particular arc in early Bleach, but it's not a complete retread, thankfully. Kubo manages to give us some really cool lore and some great surprises that made me very excited for what could come next for the series. While I'm satisfied with what we got, a part of me wishes it was longer and that he didn't cut some stuff from the limited series manga. He cut around 9 pages from the beginning of chapter 2 out of the second episode, which I really would have loved to see. Still, I understood why he probably had to cut it, either for runtime or pacing reasons. Overall, I really enjoyed Burn the Witch. I thought it was a really good anime film series slash TV show. If I had to give it a score, for me personally, I'd probably give it a 9 or a 10, but it's probably sitting somewhere between an 8.5 or just an 8. I highly recommend watching this. If you're a fan of Bleach, I think you'll get a bit more out of this, because there might be some references there that I didn't notice, because I'm not a complete Bleach head, so there are some things about Bleach that I may not know about that, if you're a hardcore fan of Bleach, this just might really appeal to you. So that's my thoughts on Burn the Witch. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. Like the video, subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time. This has been Fear No Hate. I'm out of here. Peace.